Are you wanting to streamline your digital automations and business processes? Well, let me show you how with Jotform Workflows. Hey Jotformers, welcome back. I'm Kimberly. And like I mentioned, if you are looking to streamline your business processes, our Jotform approval process has now evolved and is now called Jotform Workflows. Now with that, you can not only handle the full approval process, you can also assign tasks, you can integrate with third-party applications, and you can even process payments, all without any coding knowledge. So let me show you what this new Jotform Workflows looks like. I'm gonna go ahead and choose my form right down here. We're gonna choose more, and then I'm gonna head to view this overarching workflow. Now, workflows can be as simple as a one-step process. Someone fills out a form, you have the approval, and then it ends. But with this video, I wanted to showcase everything that Jotform Workflows has to offer. So if we take a look over on the left-hand side of the screen, we can see all of our basic workflow elements. We have our form, which is going to be right up here. We have a payment form, which we'll see right down here. Then, of course, we can add those emails, tasks. We have three different types of approvals. We have approve and sign, the regular approval, and then we also have team approval. We also have flow reports, PDFs, signed documents, and then we have some logic elements at the bottom. We have if else conditions, conditional branches, splitting, merging, and then of course the final end. Now, another piece with this, again, on the left up at the top, we have integration. So now we can add those third parties into our workflow process, allowing us to be completely hands-off. So for example, when someone fills out this very top form, we have this if-else condition. So for example, let's go ahead and look at the settings on this one. So we can see that in this form, they're going to need to upload a file. So if they didn't upload a file, if that is empty, if that is true, it's gonna automatically be denied. Then we can see if it's false, meaning they did upload something, it's gonna continue on with the process. So we can see right here, we have our approval. If we look at our settings, we have the general approve and deny outcome. If we need to add another outcome, we can do that as well. We also have our approvers. And if you would like, you can choose from our form fields. From this example, we just have the person who is filling out the form. But for example, if you would like, you can ask in their form what their supervisor's email is, and we can add from the form here. We also have some completion roles, and you can also edit those notification emails. Now again, over on the left-hand side, we did have approve and sign. So if you do need a signature of approval or denial, you can add that in here. But we can see here, if it is approved, it's gonna come down and we have this split right here. So let's say, for example, if it is approved, they're going to get that email, yes, it was approved. But because it was approved, at the same time, they're also going to have access to fill out a payment form. So maybe because they're approved, they get to purchase something from us. And that is where this product order form comes in right here. So if we click on this, we can look at our settings and we can choose, of course, that assignee email address is going to be from our form fields. We have that email right here. So we can go ahead and save this. Then next, right down here, we have a task. So once it has been approved, we can add a task to the system. So for example, this one right here, it says we're going to add this person to our system. That's the title. And then we can add more in the description, maybe very specific details of what that task needs to look like. Then if we scroll down over on the right-hand side, we get to see that assignee. Again, who is this task going to be assigned to? We can pull from the form fields again, or we can assign it to a very specific person. We can also design the task. So if I choose to design the task, it's going to look very similar to what a form is going to look like. So we can see here the title, we have the steps that need to be taken. And then of course we have the response, which is complete. Now, if we need to add more pieces to this, it's very similar to a form. We can add a field. We can choose short text, long text, single choice, multiple choice. We can add things in here to complete this task. Now, I'm gonna go ahead and head back to our workflow builder. Now, this task is gonna be in the same place as the approval process in our inbox. So we can see here that once this is complete, again, we're still on the approval side, we are going to have a Google Drive integration. So once everything is done, it's going to send a PDF of this submission to our Google Drive file. If we click here, we can come up to our gear and we can see what this looks like. We have the Google Drive folder, we can have that new document, and of course the file upload that they are giving us as a part of that file. So we can save this and exit. Now we can also have a flow report. Maybe HR doesn't need to be involved in this at all, but they do need to have the final piece of it, which is that flow report. So if I click here, we can choose our settings and we can view a sample report. So this is what it's going to look like basically in our inbox, who approved what and when. Then on the right-hand side, we can show different icons. We have different options here if we'd like to add that in, but we are good to go. Then the last piece of this is once all of that is complete, we can send a message to a public Slack channel, maybe on Monday. You get to choose from any of those integrations. I'm gonna go ahead and open this back up over here. Let's look at our integrations. We have Airtable, Asana, ClickUp. We can send information to a third party anytime within this workflow. But for this, we can see we have a message going to a public Slack channel. It's gonna go to our marketing channel. We have the name, and then we can also view that submission from within our Slack channel. Go ahead and exit out of this. Now, if we head back up to the top, let's look at if it gets denied. So right here we have a conditional branch. So let's say whenever this person fills out the form, if for any reason they're using a Gmail or a Yahoo, maybe they need to be utilizing their company email address, it's going to automatically deny their request. And then for just an example, you can also have another one coming down here to all, just completely finishing. But every piece of this is going to be editable. So for example, these approval and denial emails, we can look at these settings. We get to edit what this looks like. So if we would prefer to not have this, maybe we want to have pretty much a typed out response, we can edit this in order to include that. But it really is as simple as that. If you have any questions about how to use Jotform Workflows, and again, you can see that this is all drag and drop, no coding experience necessary. Let us know down below in the comments. If you like this video and you got some value, hit that like button and don't forget to subscribe and turn on the bell so you get notification every time we put out a new video. I'll see you next time.